We left Adelaide following the coastal road. It doesn't take long before it becomes the outback. A cold snap comes along. We visit Coffin Bay, Coffin Bay National Park, and I have a go at driving my RAV on the beach. Hi, I'm Lisa, and this is my brother Corey, and together we're travelling Australia. Beautiful view of all those mountain ranges. I'm just heading over to the little town over here. So I'm just like in a small town about 2.5 hours from the Flinders Ranges. You can see them over there. There's snow-free camp with a toilet. So the plan tonight is I'm gonna cook dinner early. Also bracing for a really cold night, so I've bought thermals, I'm gonna have my water bottle going, but yeah, I'm gonna cook dinner early to do the wash up early. I'm gonna go down the road to the boat ramp to watch the sunset, then I'll come back to this toilet. Oh, there's a change room there. I'll get changed there, go to the toilet, and then I'll drive to the free camp and then just sleep for the night and then wake up in the morning and off I go.
All the precautions that I took last night meant that I wasn't cold, but it's hard to get up in the morning because it's cold outside. That was one thing that I didn't really get in the van as well. It was quite warm to be in there, and I'll just run the cooker for like 4 minutes and the whole thing will be warm anyways. So limited space and non-insulation makes it really hard for me to get here and warm. And today it's raining, so it makes it for a long day when it's raining in a car.
Oh my god, what's Sophie doing?
Just doing a shot for the outback. Only in the outback now. Thankfully, tonight is the last cold night before the weather increases again. Got my water bottle here. That keeps me nice and warm. Also, that heated pad, which gets super hot. I just plug that into a power bank. So it's dark about 6:30, and then pretty much I've just been coming in the car, and then I put this magnet here so I can stick my phone on there, watch Netflix. I use Sophie's hat too here, just as a little bit of a charging bay for now. Till I find something better. It says here that it's 18.6 degrees, but I'd say it feels more like 10 in here. I was looking at the map before, and then I realized that today is D-Day, decision day. We're here, so if we are going north or west, we have to decide today. I can honestly say I don't know if we're going to go north or if we're going to go west.
My brother wants to travel from Port Augusta all the way to Streaky Bay before making his decision.
I had this really good idea to put my map in my bed extension. So now, it's the planning table. There is a barbecue area and stuff over there. So I filled up my water bottle. I had a drank the whole thing. Then I thought I'll take my water tank over there and fill it up. To find that the water is that color and has things swimming in it. So, now I want to throw up. So here's the Coffin Bay Yacht Club. Gonna go fishing. Hopefully we're gonna see dolphins, penguins, squid, and catch fish.
This place is like a zoo. Here comes a penguin, but he's quick. I left Corey at the jetty to fish all day while I went to the national park. He caught two tommies, which we ate for dinner. I'm here at the Coffin Bay National Park. Most of it is four-wheel drive tracks, not for beginners. It's a $12 entry fee for the day. Let's go check it out.
How beautiful is this? Okay, I found a beach that I can drive on, so I'm gonna do it.
I put the RAV in four-wheel drive mode, I didn't deflate the tires, and off I went. It might not seem much to other people, but I'm 34 years old and I've never driven my own vehicle on a beach before, so I was pretty excited.
Nice place to watch sunset.
I was most nervous about turning around to go back. For anyone who hasn't driven on the beach before, it feels a bit like ice skating or something. The tracks in the sand sort of drag the tires around to where it wants to be. When driving on the beach, it's always important to check the tire times as well to see what time the tide is actually coming in so you don't get caught out, bogged, and then underwater. by myself.
And then it was time to get back on the jetty and go fishing again.
So what I'm hoping to catch on film here is Corey fighting with another squid and getting ink everywhere. Oh, look who has crabs. That's the back of you. These pretend eyes fool you.
He was 1 centimeter too small. And then the seals come to play, but I was too late to capture it. Here we try to catch this squid. Coffin Bay was like a real life zoo experience, and I'll definitely be back. You have just watched another Bon Bon production.